That's right, guys, you read that correct. Touchscreen MacBooks are on their way and they're coming sooner than you think. So today what I want to talk about is, when are these brand new touchscreen MacBooks on their way and what other technology is coming along with them? And also the history of why we've only started to get touchscreen MacBooks now and why we haven't had them, say, 10 years ago or so. So let's first of all talk about when touchscreen MacBooks are on their way. So believe it or not, it goes back to a post that we had from Ross Young at the end of 2022, where he said that the first OLED MacBook Air is on its way and it could be coming at the end of 2024. Now, just in case you didn't know right now, the MacBook Air uses an LCD sort of retina display, and we've had this technology a long, long time. And the likes of, say, the iPads use this technology too, except for the 12.9-inch iPad Pro, what uses mini LED technology, and this technology is also in the 14 and 16 inch MacBook Pro. And this will come relevant very, very soon, as you will see. But the main thing is, an OLED display is not in any of Apple's sort of iPad lines or their MacBook lines at all at the moment. In fact, we only have OLED displays in the likes of, say, the Apple Watch, and we also have them in our iPhones. And specifically, mainly all the iPhones since the iPhone 12 have an OLED display. Don't get me wrong, the iPhone 10 was actually the first iPhone to get an OLED display, but the likes of, say, the iPhone 8, what came out that year, and the year after, every year, the iPhone 10R, and even the iPhone 11, the basic one, still had an LCD display. It wasn't until the iPhone 12 where everything switched over to OLED, and since then we've had improvements like ProMotion and things like this. But for bigger displays, we've actually had a mini LED display, as we've seen, like I said, in the iPad Pro and also in the 14 and 16 inch MacBook Pro. But if you know anything about mini LED and OLED technology, you'll know that OLED technology is a bit more superior. It gives that sort of more vibrant kind of look, and it also sort of brightens up colors, and also it's really, really power efficient. And it looks like finally this could be coming to the MacBook Air at least. Now, the reason why I'm talking about these OLED displays is because I believe there's more to the picture here. As we've seen here, we had another report coming from Min-Chi Kuo, as well as Ross Young, who said that we would be getting OLED display. He also confirmed it, Min-Chi Kuo, saying that it's coming in the end of 2024, early 2025. What does kind of make sense, that the brand new sort of MacBook Air, this is the 13-inch model, not the new Plus model we're expecting this year, that it will have the M3 chipset, will come out in 2024. Because by that sort of time, you know, I would actually say that it's probably been about, you know, just under 2 years since the M2 MacBook Air came out. So it's due that refresh around that time. But what's also most likely going to happen is, soon after that MacBook Air gets an OLED display, we'll be wondering about the likes of, say, the MacBook Pro. Well, as you know, we're expecting the 14 and the 16-inch MacBook Pro with the M2 Pro and the M2 Max to be released this year around spring or summertime. And if you do your calculations, probably around about 18 months later or so, we hit early sort of 2025, and that is when probably an OLED display will be also added to the MacBook Pro lineup. And in fact, if you look here at an article from Mark Gurman, he's also confirmed that basically touchscreen technology is coming to the MacBook Pros as well in early 2025. So this makes complete sense that for Apple to first of all make their MacBook Airs to have this OLED technology, then to move over to the MacBook Pro in early 2025 to also have OLED screen, and also to make that screen also touchscreen. So this would be, I'm talking about the M3 Pro and the M3 Max chipset, and it would have these enhancements to the 14 inch and the 16 inch MacBook Pros to have these new screens in them with touchscreen ability. So it's really, really exciting to hear that this is how Apple will be raising the bar with their displays in the next sort of generation of MacBooks after the generation that we have coming out right now. But you're probably wondering at this stage, well, why has it taken Apple so long to put actual touchscreens into their sort of MacBook sort of models and everything like that? Well, I believe it's for multiple different reasons. First of all, if we go way back around about 10, 12 years ago, when Steve Jobs was around, he even said himself that he loved the idea of a multi-touch pad on the actual sort of MacBook, and it's far easier to do that. We first got that proper sort of multi-touch sort of gesture on the original MacBook Air, and that sort of kick-started it all. And basically around that time, touchscreen sort of laptops were just starting to come out, but they weren't really popular at all at that time. Also at the same time, we had the iPad come out, and that came out in 2009 and progressed into this leading industry of tablet devices as we know right now. And for example, if Apple were to introduce touchscreen MacBooks during that growth of the iPad, you know, the iPads could have fallen flat on their feet. The iPad needs to establish itself to be its own device. I think Apple have been waiting for the perfect time to finally release touchscreen ability. Also at the same time as well, I think Apple have been a little bit reluctant. We've also have heard in the past in 2016, when we actually saw the introduction of the touch bar inside the 13-inch and the 15-inch MacBook Pros back then, that basically we were told that it's not really comfortable to use sort of a touch screen on the actual sort of a MacBook because of the angle the actual display is. So this is why the touch bar came out. And as we know the story here, the touch bar wasn't the greatest success. In fact, we've only got one model now. What is the M2 MacBook Pro 13-inch model? It has that touch bar, and we think that's going to be replaced very soon as well. So to be deadly honest, you know, everything else has moved away from that touch bar. But since then, we have had other devices that have come out for the iPad line. And what I'm talking about the Magic Keyboard Folio and the Magic Keyboard. This is the ability to actually use a touch pad and a keyboard and also touch the screen. I think Apple are warming up to the idea that they need to bring in sort of touchscreen technology into their actual displays. And basically, this is finally going to happen. And I think a big pressure behind this is because of a Gen Z sort of people out there now getting used to sort of touch screens. Gen Z people have always had sort of touchscreen technology near them, and they're kind of sort of pushing forward to say, well, why can't a MacBook have that? I'm going to admit to myself, I'm actually a millennial sort of person, and so I've been used to touchscreen sort of devices and also touchpads as well, so I can use sort of both. But mainly that Gen Z sort of generation, it's got used to using sort of touch sort of displays, and they're probably crying out there, why can't the MacBook have this? Don't get me wrong, I'm sure other generations out there, you would love it too. But basically, I think, you know, you can understand that Apple have been waiting on this to get the time right. And one thing that we've got to understand with all of this, I think it also proves the point that the iPad line will still be moving in its own separate direction, and that we probably will not see macOS come over to the iPad. Because if we do bring out sort of touchscreen abilities on the MacBook Pro, there'd be sort of no point in having one device or the other because of this. So as you know, got the Magic Keyboard, like I said, with the iPad Pro and the iPad sort of folio sort of design, you get the idea. There's just no point whatsoever putting macOS on that, because you'd sort of defeat the object of a MacBook Pro. Yes, you'd have less ports, and also it's no point doing it the other way around to bring iPad OS, crazy idea, onto the MacBooks, because again, it just makes no sense to do that. I think Apple wants to distinguish both of these products still going into the future, and the best way they can do this is just probably make slight adjustments to macOS to begin with to have touchscreen abilities. What I'm talking about like the ability for like sliders and scrollers, as it were, so scrolling through web pages with your finger, flicking it through like we do right now on an iPad. I don't think you're going to get anything sort of too intricate. I don't think we're going to get sort of Apple Pencil support maybe straight away, but we might get it in the future. You never know. We'll have to see. I think Apple are going to be sort of touching the water here just to see how much of an appeal sort of touchscreen is going to be. They do not want to make that same mistake with sort of the touch bar technology. So it's going to be really interesting to see. But the main thing to take away from this video, it does look like that touchscreen MacBooks are finally on their way, and also OLED displays are also coming to the MacBook range. So this is really, really exciting to hear. And on that note, guys, I would love to know your thoughts on the touchscreen MacBook. What do you think about them? Do you think you would love to have one, or do you think they should just leave them as sort of the multi sort of touch sort of sensor that we have right now, the actual pad? I would love to know your thoughts, so please do put them in the comments below. And also at the same time, guys, it's also time to wrap up the video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. And also, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell. Until next time, guys, I will see you really soon. Take care. Bye bye.